ancient land of Britannia awaits its new king. In this proud realm of knights and citadels, every living soul feels that a time of wonders and magic has come. The fairy lords have returned, but even they are swept away by the coming tide of mayhem. Prepare for a war, the like of which has never been seen before. Destiny.
My destiny, unfortunately, is going to be a suck. Hey everybody, it's Adam, and let's play a game, shall we? I am here with King Arthur the role-playing Wargame. Because how else can I fuck myself over by playing war strategy games? Oh, new campaign. I don't know what I'm doing. I did the original, obviously. What? Recommend for beginners totally into this game. Easy, normal. RTS games. It's probably snap pussy out and immediately just go normal.
Chris. In the darkest years of Britannia, after Uther Pendragon, the last great king, died.
It's called the Thatcher era.
It was then that the wizard Merlin summoned the warring rulers from their kingdoms. They all saw a great stone, and in the middle there was a sword inscribed with strange letters that said, "Only the true king can pull out this sword." When Arthur, the son of Uther Pendragon, pulled the sword out of the stone, suddenly everything changed in Britannia. In the wilderness, monsters awoke from their sleep. The air crackled around ancient stone circles. Something terrible happened, a cataclysm that changed the land and unleashed the tide of a terrible war.
These are all setups for nice political jokes, but I'm not gonna stir that fucking fire.
They were like giants wearing black steel and wielding strange weapons. They were powerful and invincible warriors. They might be the only hope in this age of wonders and mayhem. So begins
it's a mist man.
The tale of King Arthur and his knights of the Round Table.
Okay, sure. Book of Beginnings. Is that like your way of saying tutorial level? Because I don't know what I'm doing, I'm afraid. I'm terribly lost here. There's a map. There's a fucking lake of some sort. There's cities and towns and villages and what. Oh, look, Stonehenge. And there's a ray of light shining out of this one from the sky. It must be aliens. Clearly. That is the only logical recourse.
Sir,
oh, hello.
I am your foster father.
No, you're not.
And I brought you up as my own flesh and blood. You are my king, and I promise that I shall not fail you.
Yeah, that's kind of old, isn't it?
You are still inexperienced with the ways of warfare.
Very much.
I would be glad if I could give you advice from time to time.
I would be too.
And please accept the sword of my son, your foster brother, Sir Kay, who will be your faithful knight.
I think he needs it more than I do, to be completely honest. Yeah, okay, what? This is a tutorial panel here. You can disable the tutorials and tell me how are we going to do this? With the mouse over something, you'll see world of information. Yeah, I got an additional pop up. Yeah, panel key, the toys, the panel, you pop up. Yeah, okay. So, King Arthur, Sir Kay. Footman, Sir Kay, and Heavy Footman. Okay. Why? Many such was successful.
Ready to serve.
Okay. Move your mouse over the rebel army. Okay. Distance can travel one season. Wait. The blue line shows the path there, yeah. The blue gauge next to your army. That's down to standard gauge next to your army. What? Oh, is this? Oh. Okay, yeah, that's actually distinct from the line. Right, okay. It's just a similar color, but. Alright. However, the distance can travel one season. Press the right mouse button again to go to the location. Okay. Someone's season.
Attack.
Yes, I have to. I don't know. You can retreat. You will suffer some loss, the enemy might follow you. Extend on that. Then yourself, all battle is highest battle at once. Okay. He has bowmen. I do not. That's not a good thing. sure. Why not? Better I have some fucking idea what I'm doing, because I don't have that to begin with. That's a jolly fiddle playing in the background, that is. Those swords look very... hello. Your first task is to defeat the rebels. Who want to accept you as their king? Okay.
Your first task is to defeat the rebels.
Bit slow there, mate.
You as their king. They have burned down the village and set up their camp around the old keep.
Okay. The clicker isn't going to go out of sound. It's just circling now. Cinematic cameras. Click? No. That is. Oh. Lead your units to the forward. Okay. Hello. Camera control. Yeah. What? Use the WAS to move. Okay, forward and backwards, and pan left and right. Rotate by Q and E. Okay, that seems pretty standard. Right. Okay, that makes sense. Cool. All right. Okay. Stamp movement and stamina. All right. You can move your units by right clicking once. Obstacles like rocks, water abilities cannot be selected as destinations. So, okay. A double right click on the destination you run. By holding the right mouse, and you can set the destination. You can swim faster, it tires them quickly. Right, that all seems. Yeah. They're not going that far, Dad. For a split second, that fucking string you up there, that was like a siren or something in the background. It's like, shit, what? Units. What? Units. Why aren't you going away? Control button. What? You can select several units at the same time you hold down the control button and left click on the required units. Okay. Or the icons. Or by drawing a loser tail. Yeah, which I just did. Pressing down control A says all units and heroes. You group together all some units using control 1 to 9. Oh, interesting. Okay. Games. Yeah. Just fucking move. Come on, then. Go, Sake. Go, you water like you mean it, motherfucker. Yes. And once they get close, I'll bob it back down to 1. Just for the moment, anyway, of course. I'm sorry if I sound a bit, right now I'm a bit strung out and tired from work. Oh, and a little pissed.
The rebels are guarding the river, and they have brought archers with them. Kill them all.
Okay.
Use your spell, the Fog of Avalon.
They brought archers. Yeah, that's the bane of any medieval force. Spell. I just want to click on you and Fog of Avalon. Okay. And now it's gray. Congratulations, you fucktards. Not any skills. Yeah, some heroes perform heavenly miracles, or they have one of the ways of ancient wizardry. Wizardry! Their abilities can affect everyone in the vicinity, or even the whole army. Now, the abilities can be passive, which means they will always grant benefits, or active, meaning they cost mana. Okay, so passive. Always grant benefits, or active, meaning they cost mana. Some of them have an instant effect, others grant the for a certain time, with time on the icon. All those empowered to strike and reduce the range of the enemy archers. Oh, okay. That's very extremely useful, actually. Do I have any archers? I have footmen, heavy... No, I just have footmen. So, in other words, just fucking kill them.
Attack!
Where is the other force? What is this? Bowman? Okay, actually, we will actually take you and go hit them, I guess, since they're archers. And actually,
infantry.
Splitting up my units like this might not be the best idea, but I figure if I engage all three at once, maybe I can divert the attention of the archers. Seeing as how that's kind of their big thing, raining down arrows on a single massive target. If I can make them focus on individual targets, I hope, maybe. I'm not a tactician. I'm just going to stop there. That's all I need to say. I'm not a tactician. Inter discussion. It's just... I'm shit at this kind of stuff. I'm not a battle planner. I'm more of a foot soldier myself. I run in and kill things and let other people tell me how to do it. Oh, that never works, though. I never even listen to people ever. Any kind of game I've ever played where someone has to tell me what to do, never listen to them. Like, fuck you. I only owe personal favors to people that I know, and even then I fuck them over sometimes. I used to make an art of team killing people back on the GameCube. When you do local LAN or some bullshit. Specifically, I remember above this shit. I think it was the GoldenEye game on the GameCube. I think it was the GameCube. That's gone now! That's fucking fantastic! Where's Kay? That's timing down. Oh, hello. Engage. Can't quite see what's happening over here. There's trees in the way, some kind of shrubbery. Attack! Okay, note to self. Next time you in the game told me to do it, then I should have waited. Well, I could have had them run that too, but I didn't want to just rape their stamina, basically. Also would have been a bit suicidal. How do you get into the battle completely fucking exhausted because you're running in heavy armor? That's a brilliant idea! Okay. Destroy them all.
The rest of the rebellious army awaits you at the old tower. Destroy them all.
Uh-huh. Easier said than done, motherfucker. Now, what do they have over there? I'm assuming they have more archers somewhere. Maybe, or is that a large infantry bulk over there? Which would also kind of make sense. Oops, that's right. What do they have? That's melee units. Okay, well that... Oh, shit. Trees! No. It looks like it's all melee units. And they have war scythes. Oh, that's terrific. War scythes. Awesome. Great. Surprisingly effective weapons war scythes were, actually. Mostly because they were not real scythes. Real scythes were flimsy as fuck and couldn't do shit. And they normal. And even then, when you put a blade like on a scythe when it's turned downward, that's probably the worst weapon imaginable because it's extremely awkward in terms of how the weight is balanced. And even then, so it's only slow and ungainly, but then you have to catch whatever's on the inside of the blade. And I believe that Lindy Beige, I think it was him who said, like, unless your enemy is weak, you're not going to have much of an easy time actually hitting them with it. But a war scythe, however, you put it standing up, the momentum, therefore, carried. And obviously with the blade now being an upwards curve like that, you had more range and hide an ambush. Force one of the special terrain types, where units can hide. Hiding units don't appear on the minimap and their flag is also hidden. Shell Cry Observers is still possible to locate them on the ground. Huh. Can I tell them to hide then for a bit? Oh. Or have they been hiding? Is it the point? Oh, it is. It is. They've been hiding. They've been hiding. That's fantastic. That's fucking brilliant. Should have guessed. Well, that's why I was in red, not blue. The trees! They're coming out of the trees! I can't use it, as I'm not using it. So, this is... Well, I don't know if this means I can't use those yet for some reason, or if that just means I haven't, like, I'm not using one of those. The little red marked over me. Riveting. Oh. Alright. Rebels. No, oh, yeah, some dance for a bit. Oh, fucking hell. There we go. That clusterfuck's done now. Yeah, just fucking kill them all. Oh, great, we're fighting in the woods. Oh, my neck. Ah. Come, visit the woods. Oh, hello. Don't worry, man. It's just an invisible camera coming through your masses. Oh, hello, heavy infantry. That's cool of you. And they have morning stars. I believe there's almost a giant fucking mace with spikes on it. I don't remember. Ah, yes. This is a double edge, too. What are you, Darth Maul? You motherfucker, you get killed. Fuck off. Go to hell. In a handbasket. The old gods will see you down. Yes, I've heard this. I've done a minor bit of reading on this. Apparently, there's like, you can choose between Christianity and paganism. I don't know if it's like a hard choice, like you have to choose one or the other. But, like, both of them have their own benefits. I don't know what those benefits are. Or what the population... I'm assuming there's, like, maybe a descent kind of factor as well. Depending on what, I guess, he chooses Arthur's chosen religion as compared to the other... The subjects. Their preferences. So, I don't know. But I'm attempting to go, like, fucking pagan. Full fucking heathen on this shit. I would just smack them. Where's the rest? Where are they? Oh, hello. Oh, hello. God is happy. That's why there's a ray of sunlight there. Or maybe I'm Solaire. Praise the sun, motherfuckers. I lost... Jesus. I still lost 68 fucking men. Yeah, okay. Oh, that was... painfully, me, really. That's... A tutorial, I don't want to jack the fucking thing up, because I don't know what I'm doing. Thick as fuck. Right, in this panel you will see statistics about current battle losses on both sides and rewards. Okay! Kill them all. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. The first victory! Then very well, my king. You have successfully defeated the band of rebels. Now I humbly ask that you heed my advice, my lord. Not far from here on the northern shore, you'll find the castle where a rebellious duke is trying to gather a bigger army. Attack immediately while he is still weak. A group of archers has just arrived to help your cause. Them with you. Cool. Two bowmen and light cavalry. Yes, give me those horses. Oh, I should do naughty things with horses. I should write that something bad. Right, that's him then. Yeah, that's... He's mistrustful. Oh, he's mistrustful. He's looking out with his fucking... telescope. I don't think they have... Those are a bit of... Quite yet. He's just looking over the fucking... over the distance, glowering over here. I don't trust that person who just destroyed my allied army. Yes. Very mistrustful of them indeed. Okay. Let's just fuck him up. Manager army getting all your units. Okay. Here we go. Time is divided into seasons. You can see the current season in the upper left. Turn to spring. Move your pointer over to get more detailed information. Press in turn, lower right corner to advance the season. The beginning of the year, when new quests and new characters appear on the map. After exceptionally harsh winters, spring might start with N. With an uprising of the hungry people of the realm. Spring is the most timely season to go adventuring. Alright. Now it's summer. Time for military campaigns, and weather is more suitable for long marches and waging battles. During the summer season, heroes and armies have more movement points. Okay, draw autumn and spring. Okay, interesting. So, now can I move him? Yes, I do believe I can. Attack. Smack that castle. Yeah, hit it good. Right, he's got people and bowmen, and I've got a few bowmen now. Unique mechanics. This thing event will be concentrated on our unique game mechanics. It is highly advised with a story about. Okay, fine. Right. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, no. Forest of the Hill, Plain Forest. River Forest Hill. Many wars are changing the name of the Penny Rooms. You're playing with where else you're playing, some dragons fought many wars in ancient. Obviously, all places a hill, I have archers. Archers should be best utilized from a hill, I assume. Don't know if that's actually going to be all limited to the fighting hand, but you know, that's what you think about. Archers are best used from a high point. Someone on the fleet decided to build be the old folk worship the gods of the way. Between the hills of the forest, put down everyone in the cliffs in the blue sea. Be able to see underneath and use a turn daily trap. Yeah, fuck it. Look over here. This sword is a paddle. Lacking vanilla weapons? That's a purlin. Nope. Okay. Giant banner. And the sunlight. Yeah, see, it's still there. Told you. Oh, shit. Okay. Alright. I'm gonna take all these, aren't I? That's the point. As I said, five victory locations. It means that they destroy five things to get a victory. Alright. Is that a church of some sort? Yes, I believe it looks like some kind of cathedral. I'm gonna ransack that and kill some nuns. And some kind of religious. Alright, well. A shrine or something there, I guess. Okay. Right. Victory bar. At the beginning of the battle, the victory bar shows basic setting where blue marks level the morale and red marks the enemy side, and the whole gray bar represents the health of the enemies. Okay. Oh, wait, the blue marks level your morale and red marks the enemy's morale. Okay, and the whole gray bar represents the... If any sides lose units, the graveyard starts to sink and some of the morale is lost. That side loses the battle. At the beginning of the battle, the sides are... Great. Okay, so what are my archers? Bowman, right. So, nope. That is in your right upper corner of the screen. You can create the suits by choosing from the available ranks. Choose. Okay. Arms are the various combat branches of the army. Soldiers serving in various arms differ in armory. Light infantry, heavy infantry, cavalry, knights, spearmen, and archers. Important to note the age of these groups here to make it so you give an army branch. Okay. Yeah. Various strength types influence the outcome of battle. Playing fields are good for horsemen and heavy infantry. Light infantry is more effective in a forest, while hard, rocky terrain and scrambles are good for archers. Right. Spearmen stand on ground, other ground on any heavy terrain, as long as they can keep their formation. Only infantry can take the only at close range against. Okay. Sure. Right. I don't immediately see anyone here, so there's no one here or they're in the forest. Speaking of which, there's two over there. Oh, great. Oh, I see. Okay. Here's their force over here. Bowman. Okay. So are they leaving contingent? No, they're just leaving. Okay. Right. I see. Great. Okay.
Infantry.
You can't go there.
Cavalry.
Nope. Oh, even skills. Even skills can be passive or active, which grant. You can use dodge. Get some protection. Okay. Interesting. They're all coming this way. Awesome. I'm losing morale now. Okay. And it just stops. Right. I just not, like, send you over here. Oh, they have a... That's actually a sizable force. You know what? Nope. I think. We may want to just try and kill them. I don't know. Okay. I didn't think of that one, though. What's my. Go down.
Infantry.
Attack! just cut them up right here, then we lessen the damage and we actually get involved in them. Not any skills. Right, what? Yes. Thank you. Yes. How do I... Yep. You assholes doing. So can you actually not claim a place because you're not like a hero or something? Is that the idea? I think that's what area. I'm assuming that might be what that must be that means actually. Since apparently they can't do shit to it. Oh, never mind. I have to go up the road apparently. Go grab that one. Quickly now. And they're recalling their forces. Cool. What are you guys doing? Are they all dead over here? They look to be. Alright, cool. Actually, where those motherfuckers go? Where are they? The advancing force. Oh, great. Where's the advancing force? Or did they go into like a forest area and I can't see them? That's why. I just saw them a second ago. Up, up, up. Oh, there they are. What are they? They're melee. Infantry. Oops. Archers. So you can't melee them a little bit. Just hit them. Hit them hard. You a sneaky motherfucker and just say, go over here. Just go take that. Can I do that? Let's find out, shall we? I'm curious.
Oh, kind of naked is now, yo.
What are you motherfuckers doing?
Attack!
Kill them, you idiots!
Archers.
Where the fuck are they going? Hey! Oh. I guess they were going back to their mothers. Alright, well. Oh, hello, who are you? Oh, yes. I do like, how can has get, you know, the usual. Hello. Okay. Your opponent's Cornwall. Yeah, I got Cornwall. A glimpse of hope. The battle-hardened veterans of the long battles of the South seek a new king to serve. Some would like to join your army. Oh! Heavy footman, indeed. Press the intern. Defeat one of the...
To you, my lord. In Uther Pendragon's time, the two neighbors, Dorset and Demnonia, were the two most influential provinces of the South.
I see.
Now, King Idris, the tyrant of Dorset, has decided that the time is right to raid the neighboring lands. King Mark, the rightful ruler of Demnonia, is preparing for the fight. Each of these kings wants your help, and each offers a different reward.
Oh, great! Oh, hello. Rewards. King Mark and his soldiers join your army. The longest war is only devastating for Britannia. Whether proof is needed, Dorset, the treacherous monarch. Defeat. Ooh. Under the dwellers. Well, money and a sword. Ooh. I don't know. I mean, support a rightful thing? A rightful king here? Or the fucking tyrant? I don't, who isn't gonna give me money and a sword? Oh, Oh, no. Someone imagine. You have several chapters unlocked at the same time, but you have to face the individual. Okay. Apart from the standalone objectives, in some cases your chance really changes because some objectives are essentially decided on a story, but we want to, you know, actually complete it right. If you're on the objective, you will get to the information. Okay. Right. Oh. Yeah, that's that too. King Mark will actually join me. He'll actually. He and his soldiers will join the army. Whereas this guy just gives me a sword and a lot of money. Oh no. That's not an easy choice for me to make. Do I add some additional forces to my, to mine? Do I absorb them into my fold? You know, tasty. Or do I, plus the whole rival, then I can be a good person, you know, fucking paragon interrupt there. Or I can be a renegade here. That's 48,000 monies. Oh no. New season autumn. Okay, what's autumn? The time of harvest, when you prepare for the coming winter, taxes and food arrive from the provinces. Okay. Autumn is a last chance to go into battle. To conquer liberate province, armies cannot move in the winter. Right. Okay, so. Basically. Defeat one of the armies. I have to go either fight King Mark or Idris. Do I know anything? No, it's just gonna. Oh, Sir Glyce. Can I not, like, click? Oh, fine. I don't know. I honestly don't know. You know what? This episode's gone long enough to make it over. I'll think about it, I guess, and decide what I want to do later. I don't know. I really don't know. Anyway, any feedback, anything would be appreciated. You know, tell me how much I suck or whatever. I don't fucking care. Just, you know, here it is. This is how it stands. And this is, I don't even know where I stand as the thing. I don't know what I'm fucking doing anymore. I hope you enjoyed the episode. And thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you next time. Oh, dear.